Good morning, my dear friends. I am Prashant Mavani and I warmly welcome all of you to StudyIQ. I hope you all are doing good. Today is 19th March and let's see what we have got in the Hindu today. I have got a very positive start for you guys. Life is better when you smile, but I would like to add that it is best when you can laugh. So laugh loudly, keep on laughing and make your life the best one you can have. With this, we have many important articles today. Today is Monday. You know that on Mondays we get many articles in this two pages, editorial and op-ed page. So we will start with this one, right? This one is about politics, Andhra Pradesh, and particularly Andhra Pradesh politics. And you know, recently then the central government and Andhra Pradesh ruling party, they are not with each other anymore because of this special category status. Now this state is asking for special category status for a very long period of time, and you know, finance minister said that it is not possible to allot this special category status because of this 14th finance commission. You know, we talked about this thing that government has accepted this recommendations of 14th finance commission, and there was an article as well a couple of days ago. It was written by a member of 14th finance commission, and he explained that how this special category status things works, and it is just about, means there is no mention of this SCS in its 14th finance commission report and other things. We talked about this thing, you know the reason as well. Now SCS stands for 90:10 ratio. The normal ratio is 60:40 and things like that. So having recalled all this important items associated with special category status. Now the thing is, this article is talking about the problems that, or you can say the demand that was first led by this opposition party in Andhra Pradesh. It asked for this special category status. At that point of time, this ruling party, Mr. Naidu, tried to explain its means basically people of Andhra Pradesh that government is ready to give us extra money that will look after all our deficit and other things because of this bifurcation of Telangana from Andhra Pradesh created a bit of problem in economically and otherwise as well. Some of the industries now are in Telangana. They don't have a capital yet, this Andhra Pradesh. So there are many problems that are faced by it, and central government has accepted this thing as well. But the thing is, 2019 we are going to see general election, as well as this state is going for its legislative election. So the demand for this special category status has gone up in this state of Andhra Pradesh, and the government which was the state government which was earlier on talking about this extra money that central government has promised to provide, it now it is asking for this special category status, and because of that they have bifurcated from this alliance, or they have stepped out of this NDA's umbrella. And then you have this Polavaram irrigation project issue, their capital, this Amravati, and they need more money for that and other things. So this is a political article. You can go through it. It will give you a good insight on how things are working, and this sort of things are important for you as well, right? Just read it once or twice, depending on your necessity, but go through it. The reason is it will help you with your English comprehension that you have to prepare for your GS2, right? Your prelims, paper number 2. And apart from that, it will give you a good insight of how things are going on. Because remember, when you will crack your exam, you have to work with politicians and political parties and other people as well, right? So it is good that you have developed a good understanding on things that are going on in our country. Then this article, this lead is about the recent changes that have taken place. You know, in Andhra Pradesh, not in Andhra Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, this by-election results are out, and BJP has lost basically in this by-election, and this regional parties, they have had their victory after a very long period of time. They went through some rough phases, and this is going to create, of course, problems for BJP, no doubt, because Gorakhpur is considered as a den of Yogi Adityanath, and if he is losing in this Gorakhpur, then this is a big thing for BJP as well as Yogi Adityanath. Apart from that, you see Gujarat election, right? It was a tough victory for, it was not a sort of easy cakewalk for BJP. So there are things that are going against BJP at present. We can see in South as well, they don't have that much reach. There are some other states like West Bengal, left government is there. And of course, in recent time, we have seen their victory, and at present, Narendra Modi is quite famous. But I'm sure you might have heard about this thing that there are some headwinds that BJP has to face in the upcoming election. Now, this article is talking about, see, we have seen this opposition parties, they are coming together. Earlier on, they were against each other. But now they are going to be one, and they are going to take over, or they are going to take or stand against BJP. So this is the thing that we are seeing. Now, this article is saying that, and this is right as well. See, we find many political leaders, or opposition leaders, or leaders who are not in power at present, they are visiting many temples, and they are talking about this anti-Hindutva that is associated with BJP and other things. But one thing is that people in our country, right, we are not naive. Now, people in our country, they understand all these games of politicians, may it be ruling party or opposition party. So trying to win election by you know, talking about religion and caste and other things, gradually we are seeing that it is getting out of date. The other thing is, what people really want is a good leader. They want a strong leader. They want a leader who is having conviction in him or herself, and they want delivery of results. At the end of the day, what we are aspiring for, and this is something that all political parties should understand, that people in our country, now we aspire for better life. And you might have seen this thing, development. It's not just about Modi ji that he is talking about development, but in true sense, right, what we are seeking is development. We need better life, better jobs, better business opportunities, better livelihood, fundamental rights are protected, you know, health services and other social indicators. Because if we compare ourselves with other countries in this social indicators, then we find that even today we are lagging very far behind. The other thing is, if we go back in the history, then we find something similar was going on in Soviet Union as well. During 1980s, right, people in Soviet Union, they were looking at the life of European people, and they came to know this thing, that people in Europe were far ahead of them in living standards. And something similar is visible in our country as well. Now, we know that we compare ourselves with China. We know that there are many people. Of course, China is having its poverty and other issues are there in China. But there are people who are stepping out of poverty because of the development and growth that is going on in China. And we also compare ourselves with other countries. Recently, these reports were out, and we found ourselves in a very bad position compared to countries like Bangladesh and other countries. So people in our country, generally speaking, they are comparing the situation of Asian countries, and they are comparing it with the life in India. So these are the things that political leaders should keep in mind. So these two articles are done. Of course, I will recommend you guys to go through it. As I told you, it will help you with your comprehension and your reading skills and other things. Before moving ahead, this is my Facebook page. You can download the PDF of this lecture from my Facebook page. You can get in touch with me as well, and you can follow me as well for all important updates. StudyIQ provides pen drive and tablet courses for various different exams. At present, Navratri sales are going on, so check out studyiq.com to find out how much you can get off from this UPSC courses, optional pen drive courses and defense. And we have got this test series out there for you guys. This will help you immensely for your prelims preparation. With this, let's move on to editorials. The first one that we have is, let me quickly show you this thing again so that you know what we have got on table. This one is about India and Pakistan. Yesterday we talked about this diplomatic row that is going on between both these countries. This one is about very interesting article on plastic, how dangerous plastic is. And this one is about Hill State, Darjeeling particularly. And from this article, we will try to understand how peace is important in attracting investment. And here you have one article on UK and Russia. You know, things are going on between them because of this Salisbury attack. So, right, let's start with this Editorial, Dangerous Spiral. Now, there is an urgent need to address allegations of harassment going on between both these countries. We have a news item as well today. India has issued a new written note to Pakistan because of this ongoing harassment. Pakistan is doing the same thing. Pakistan is alleging that India is doing all these dirty tricks, and we are saying that they are doing these dirty tricks and things like that. Now, remember, we talked about a very interesting article a couple of days ago. And it was about three phases when we used to talk, then talks and bombardment or attacks were going on. And at present, we have seen that rather than using normal pistols and other soft, you can say, weapons, now we are using heavy weapons against each other. So this is a very, you can say, dangerous situation that is going on between both these countries. Now, surveillance, right, keeping an eye on diplomats is something that is very common. It is not new. It happens all across the board in all different countries, right? Even those countries with which we have good relationship, they will keep an eye on our activities and we will do the same thing. So this is something that is not new. But what we are seeing at present is this 3 a.m. doorbell rings, right? This sort of things are very dangerous. You can imagine it is very frightening and it impacts your personnel as well, right? It will, of course, psychologically impact them. They know that their country is behind them, but if we go back in history, then we have seen many this types of incidents, and then they lead to fatality and attacks and other things. We also are seeing this milk and newspaper and other important items are not provided or delivered. Then you find obscene phone calls, and missions are saying that their personnel were being targeted. And this is taking place again. Both these countries are alleging the same thing. Pakistanis are saying that we are doing this sort of things, that their diplomats are being stopped on the road. We are saying the same thing to them. So, of course, if they are doing something bad to our people, then it is a sort of pressure tactics that we apply on their people as well. So, tit for tat, basically, you can say. But what about violations of conventions, right? We have many important international conventions that safeguard this diplomats and diplomatic houses. And we have two. I would like to present it to you here. And please pay attention to this one. Many a times you can use, you don't have to go through the whole convention. You should just get the gist of how it works and why it is important. So you have two items here. Vienna Convention on Diplomatic Relations, 1961. And then you have Vienna Convention on Consular Relations, 1963. You can use this as in your main answer writing. If you are talking about something, then you can use this 1961 and 1963's conventions to add more weight. And this will project you, or your answer will look more logical. It will make more sense and things like that. So this is the reason why I have added this thing on our discussion today. Now, what they stand for, these two conventions, they stand for this thing that if your diplomats are living somewhere, say for example, our diplomats are living in Pakistan, so it is the responsibility of Pakistan to protect our diplomats, right? Receiving state is responsible for the protection of this diplomats. And the other thing is, remember, I'm sure you might have watched the Mahabharata and Ramayana, and there was a very beautiful film called 300. If you remember the scene of 300, in the very beginning of the film, you find this thing that a person from outside, a messenger basically, comes in and he's been chucked in the well. So before that, he says that no person can harm messenger. So this was something that is going on for a very long period of time. Right, and this is part of diplomacy. But when you see this sort of things going on, then it impacts the whole relationship, because the next thing that can happen is we can recall our diplomats from there. We can scale down our missions over there, like different consular offices and things that we have in Pakistan, and they can do the same thing. And diplomacy, remember, is a form of defense. When talks fail, confrontations goes up. So this is very important. Remember statement of Sushma Swaraj. She said when this Doklam thing was going on in Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha, basically in the parliament, she said that we have to talk, means if we want to end a war, just in case if we are in a state of war with China, then to end a war as well, we have to talk. So it is better that we talk now rather than talking after war. So diplomacy is a defense, and it is, you can say, the last line. If diplomacy fails, or if your talks fail, then you are in a state of war. So we don't need this thing at all. It is not good for our development. It is not about that we are scared of them or they are scared of us. Both are nuclear powers. We are neighbors. Things are bad, I know, but we should sort out this issue, and political will as well as both countries should take their stand. Only then one country cannot sort out this problem. And at the same time, we talked about this thing. I'm sure you know this thing, that ceasefire violations are going up and up. Today, I have one more news item for you guys. It is about the ceasefire violation and how it is destroying people in both parts of the, in both countries here. So this article is basically, the last line is, cooler council must prevail. And that is right. Moving on to another editorial, and it is about this plastic world, in a plastic world on safe bottled water. Now, if you go through the figures at present, then we find that global production of plastic is at present 300 million tons per year. This has been said by United Nations Environment Program, and this is a very bad thing, because at present we find plastic in our environment, we find it in our coastlines, in lakes, in rivers, even in our food, and even it is in the soil. Now, you have this microplastic, and it is very dangerous thing, because recently there was a report on this microplastic, and nowadays it means we have found this thing that even this safe bottled water, this water bottle that we buy, right, we consider it as a pure water bottle, or the water in this bottle is pure, but we know that it is in plastic containers. And this microplastics, right, they enter our body, because technically speaking, microplastics are particles of less than 5 mm, and then they enter our body from various different things. We have them in our environment from this industrial products and this scrubbers and cosmetics and other items, and then they dissolve in this water bodies and soil and water table, and then they enter our body. So it is creating basically many health issues at present. Then you have this synthetic microfibers that are released when we wash our clothes, and then they enter, or finally they merge with this water bodies and sea. So they are polluting our water bodies, they are killing this sea diversity as well, and then eventually you know that everyone will get affected by it. Apart from that, we have this climate change and other things that are going on. Now, health impact may not yet be clear, but indisputably there are, these things are contaminants. Particularly this microplastics are very dangerous. You can compare it with this PM particles, right, particulate matters 2.5 and 1.0 that we find in our air, and you know how they enter our body, because they are very tiny. Even our protective shield that we have in our nose, right, this tiny hairline that we have basically protects these foreign particles, but this PM particles are so tiny that they enter our lungs, and then they stick there, and then they cause cancer and other lungs related diseases. Something similar takes place with this microplastics. They enter our body from various, even in our vegetables. Nowadays we are using too much of chemicals, isn't it, for fast production and other things. We will see this thing. See, summer is just around the corner, and we will find chemical being used. We'll find this news reports of chemical being used in watermelons and mangoes and other things. Now, if we go through research at present, then we find that the need of the hour is that we need more global coordinated effort. We need more research on this thing. The good thing is that back in 2017, in Nairobi, United Nations countries, they gathered here in Nairobi, and they decided that in next 18 months, they will come out with an agreement that will ban this plastic, or there will be a substantial reduction in the use and production of plastic. In India, the biggest problem that we find is this single-use shopping bags. In many foreign countries, they have totally banned production of plastic, the single-use plastic bags. You get plastic, but this is not this cheap plastic that we find in our country. And I think we have talked about this thing, you know, this Mumbai floodings that took place, this urban flooding that took place back in 2017. One of the biggest causes was this blockage of pipelines, apart from this natural cause of heavy rainfall in a very short period of time, and there was a tidal surge as well at that point of time. Not tidal surge, but it was a high tide, so it becomes a bit difficult for us to get rid of the water. In fact, the water comes in. So this were some natural you can say causes, but the bigger reason was this blockage of our pipelines, gutters and other things, and one of the biggest culprit is this plastic. Now I'm not sure whether you have heard about this thing called Great Pacific Garbage Patch. If you go in the Pacific Ocean, right in the center of Pacific Ocean, just above equatorial portion of Pacific, you find a huge garbage pileup over there. And there are many countries, what they do is they load all this plastic and other garbage, and then they just chuck this whole thing into ocean. So this is destroying marine life as well. As you can see, this is a picture for you. You can go through it. There are many important details here, and you see how long it takes. Like, of course, you might be aware about this thing, that if you chuck plastic in ocean, then it will take 450 years for it to decompose entirely. And then you have not just plastic, you have other items. This article is just about plastic, but imagine other items that we find here, glass bottles, and we find nappies and food items. In fact, this food items, they take what, 2 months, around 2 months time to get completely dissolved. So this, all things are polluting our oceans and seas. And then we fish all these items, and means when we go for fishing, and this fishery products, they are part of our diet, and then they enter in us as well, and then they create this immune problem and other things. Now, solid waste management rules, as per this article, they are going to be applied from April 8th, and this can be achieved only, you know, segregation of waste. Again, we talked about this thing as well, that it is very important that we segregate waste. It becomes easier for us to recycle them, and we can wealth from waste is a new concept, and there are many good example best practices around the world that we can apply here, and we can use it for our cheap compost as well. It will boost our organic farming. At present, there is a huge demand of organic farm. Yesterday we were talking about this thing, that in global market, organic food is something that is in high demand, and this can help us achieve our target of doubling farmers' income, because input costs will go down, and people can make a bit of money as well out of it. So segregation is something that we should seriously work on, and this can be achieved only with the help of awareness drive and partnership of community as well as government and other people. Now, European Union, they have their own vision of 2030. Like, they are going to change the very nature of plastic. At present, there are many countries in Europe, they have banned this cheap plastic, and they are allowing plastic, but from cheap and disposable plastic, they are moving towards this durable and reusable and fully recyclable plastic. I have a very good example of this recyclable plastic that we can use in different sectors. A health sector one is, we have a news item, very inspiring thing that has taken place in Pakistan. We will talk about it. So these are the dangers of plastic, a big topic associated with your climate change, associated with your topic on pollution in general, air pollution, soil pollution, food pollution and other things. And it will be a big thing in future if we don't curb this thing, because it can turn out to become a very big public health issue as well. All these items are important for your examination, because they are part of your syllabus as well. Now, moving on to this article about Darjeeling. You know it very well that last year Darjeeling faced this 104-day shutdown because of this Gurkhaland issue. Now, West Bengal government has been trying very hardly to project this West Bengal state as an industrial state, but at present it is tagged as an anti-industrial state, and Mamata Banerjee, she recently had this meeting, this summit was conducted in West Bengal to woo or to attract industries in West Bengal. It is very beautiful state, no doubt. It has natural resources and other things as well, but political stability is very important. Without security, I have said it again and I'm repeating myself here again, and I'm sure you know this thing, you can appreciate this thing, that without stability, without security, you cannot woo, or industrialists, right, they will not invest in your state if you cannot provide a safe environment over there. We can host many investment summits and other things, but they will calculate all this thing, because what happens is that if political problems are going on in a state, if the government is not stable, then you know that next year or after, means if there is going to be a change of guard, then a new government will come out with new policies, and this sort of things are not, means a person who is investing in your state will look for consistency in rules and regulations. And when you have these political problems, it impacts your transportation, your production and other things. You have to keep some day offs or week offs, and this adds, or this are all unnecessary expenses. So this is the thing, and Darjeeling has been on a roller coaster ride with a fragile peace and minimal development, and you see this sort of things are, means as per the an estimate, 500 crore loss in 104 days shutdown, right? It cost this tea industry 500 crore rupees, and we don't have any figures as far as this loss of tourism sector is concerned, and we don't have any calculation of this aftershock as well, or this tarnished image of this Darjeeling. It was, I remember that Darjeeling was a very famous tourist destination for young couples particularly. It is famous for tea as well. 22% of West Bengal's population is living in this Darjeeling and nearby area or near neighboring districts. And then you have 24% of land is occupied by this portion, Darjeeling and its neighboring district. So it will impact your state GDP production as well. Darjeeling tea is famous all across the world, right, for its quality production. As I told you, it is famous. It used to be at present, because of this 104 days chokehold, its image has got a bit of, you know, it has taken a toll. But it was a very famous honeymoon destination for younger couples. And now we have this better information technology, information and technology and other things, and you know, WhatsApp, and so it's easy for us to promote a place nowadays as far as peace and stability is there. We have good transportation facility, and these things can, these technologies and good transportation can unleash your potential. You can convert your place or your state into a beautiful tourist destination, and this will create jobs. And people, when they have good source of a stable source of livelihood, right, you will find less screamices and less this sort of conflicts in your state. So very important for all the states to keep this. Applies to every political setup, it applies to our country as well. We still don't have this research, or we don't have this exact factual data regarding how much we are losing, because of in many different states we find this sort of problems going on. Then we have this left-wing extremism affected states as well. Then you have this Gaurakshaks and other people. Then you know, this film industry, when they are releasing a film, and many times we find this protest going on against a book or songs and other. There are many things. These are just a few examples that I'm presenting to you. So we don't have data on how much we are losing or how much our image is being damaged because of this sort of things. But states, they can geotag this beautiful places. They can place, or they can place this locations on domestic as well as international tourism map, and they can attract huge amount of investment as well as a huge amount of tourists may pop down to your place, and then everything will be fine for the people as well as for the state. So this is the thing about this article. Now moving on to this one about UK and Russia. We know this diplomatic standoff getting severe and severe. It is getting exacerbated between these two countries here, Britain and Russia, right? They are applying the same tactic what is going on between India and Pakistan, tit for tat. So they are recalling their diplomats and they are shutting down their official ties with Russia, and Russia is doing the same thing. Now, one thing that they have ignored, particularly Britain, is about this two possibilities. Either the nerve agent, this chemical, either it could be used by this Russian state or the government, or it could be possible that this thing might have fallen into hands of some rogue people or rogue organization, and they might have used it to create this sort of problems in between these two countries here. And now we find this USA, France, Germany, all this West world, right, Western world, they are against Russia. France was saying earlier on that it will go through evidence and then it will take a stand, but now it is saying that it has been done by Russia. And you have again this protocol convention. It is known as Organization for Prohibition of Chemical Weapons Convention. And this one calls for, this OPCW calls for a joint investigation before a judgment is passed. Now, Russia has accused Britain that you are afraid of a genuine professional discussion on topic. In United Nations, Russia has said this thing. So it is a sort of sad, or you can say not that accurate judgment of Britain. Of course, this attack has taken place in the land of UK, but they have to follow this OPCW. They are not following this OPCW's protocol at present. Then you have this Nobel Peace Prize laureate as well. He took part in this Kisner chemical weapons destruction facility last year. And this thing, the whole report said that this 39,000 plus or 40,000 metric tons of chemical weapons of Soviet era are basically destroyed safely. So Russia is not having this weapons at present. And we have to also take this thing into our mind that in the past as well, many top intelligence agencies, they have made mistake, like MI6, that is this James Bond agency of UK, they made a mistake on Saddam. They thought, or their input was, that Saddam was carrying all these weapons and other things, but later on they found that this was not right. So there are many mistakes conducted by intelligence agencies as well. So it is better that both the countries are following this OPCW's protocol. They do a joint investigation and then they can come to a conclusion. The other thing is that UK or London is infamous for this foreign illicit money as well. You know, many of our absconders are living over there. They transfer their money over there, and many a times it looks very sweet for a state, but then when you are allowing this foreign illicit money, then you are also bringing in criminals and this sort of problems. You are also attracting this sort of problems in your country or your city. Moving on to news item, that's everything regarding articles. We find this rhetoric going on, or allegations by Congress or opposition party against this BJP, and again BJP is doing the same thing, because remember 2019 election, the preparation has begun, and Pakistan selling. We have this two news item, this severity of relation between both these countries. This Pak shelling has killed five members of a family in Jammu and Kashmir, and then you have one more note, a verbal sent to Pakistan. This is the 13th that Delhi has sent this year. This note verbal is basically, we are expressing this our anguish that our diplomats are not being looked after, or their safety is compromised. Three AIMS doctors are killed on Yamuna Express Highway. Now, this is not the first time. We talked about a couple of days ago, remember? I think a couple of weeks ago, a big accident took place in Gujarat, a truck, and somewhere around 30, 31 people died, and there are other. So this sort of road accidents are a big killer in our country. Army is going to buy air defense system. You have different tenders from Russia, from Sweden and France. And this one is about an act on foreign funds to parties. What happens is, when you are getting foreign funds, so you are indirectly, means other countries can influence your politics. So this is not, in terms of security, it is a bit dangerous. And by amending this thing, and now government has allowed that it will become a bit easier for parties to accept foreign funds. So go through all these items and the article as well. It is very good one for you guys. Rohingyas are seeking that they want to return to their home villages. An emergency has been revoked in Sri Lanka. Putin is back again. He's going to stay for 6 more years. He's a very powerful leader in Russia and considered as one of the most powerful leader in the world as well. Election took place in Russia and now he is the victor. Then Turkey-led force, they have seized control of this Afrin, and you have this Kurdish force. Turkish government is against this Kurdish force. It's a big political hodgepodge over here. You have a special video lecture on this Kurdish people. I have delivered it some 5-6 months ago. You will find it in our playlist, so you can go through it if you want to understand this whole issue bit in more in-depth fashion. Recently, one of my colleague, Dr. Mahipal Singh Rathore, came out with a special video lecture on this Syria crisis as well. So I will reckon you guys to go through both this video lecture as per your schedule, as it fits in your schedule. And then you have this Pakistan news again. USA has clearly warned that Pakistan needs to do a bit more when it comes to Taliban and other groups, or else it will take a unilateral action. You have some business news, and this is the news. This is about RBI, and this item is about this woman doctor that I was talking about. This plastic, recycled plastic, is used for this stethoscope, and now this, you know, Doctors Without Frontiers using telemedicine or e-technology in medical field, and how it will help in sorting out problems. Particularly, imagine when you have this problems that are going on in Yemen, in Syria, this eastern Ghouta state, where you cannot, I mean, United Nations and other humanitarian helps are not able to go there. So if you have this internet connectivity, with the help of that, you can diagnose patients, and then you can send, of course, you have to send medicine. At present over there, you cannot send medicine, but in other areas, you can sort out this sort of problems and natural calamities and other things. So telemedicine in this term is a very big thing. And then you have this Bilaspur, which is in Himachal Pradesh. ANSI, Anthropological Survey of India, they have found some important evidence, Stone Age tools in Shivalik culture. So this one you will find in the national page of the Hindu. I will reckon you guys to go through it. I have added important bits or important lines here, that the oldest Acheulean site in our country is in Tamil Nadu. Now this is a new site that we have found. But this type of questions you find in your mains examination. I don't think so we'll find an article on this thing, but important for your MCQs. Sorry, not mains, but MCQs. That's everything that we have got. These are your answers. These are your questions. 3 questions today. And don't forget to check out studyiq.com. Discounts are going on this Navratri season. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Many students, you have asked that when do I come live? See, this is not a live lecture, right? Of course, when I'm recording it, it is in one shot, but it's not live. It is, we upload it and then you can see it wherever you like. But I will reckon you guys to subscribe our channel and then hit the notification bell. So every time when we upload a lecture, you will get a notification on your phone or on your email. And then you can follow it. Roughly, it is somewhere around 9:30. The English version is around 9:30. Many times, if we have many articles, many important news items, so 10-15 minutes plus and minus can take place. But 9:30 is a general time when you get this English version. So that's everything. Don't forget to give us your like if you have learned something out of it. I'm sure you all have enjoyed your Sunday, and have a good day ahead. See you all soon. Take care. Goodbye, Jai Hind.